Hello everybody, welcome back to the Awesome Goalkeeper. I just want to quickly say a massive thank you for 101 subs. It's as incredible to suddenly hit 3 digits. So I just want to thank every single one of you subscribers for that. It's absolutely incredible. So whilst in between the two episodes, I've made a second team sheet for the training. I know we did that originally, but I sort of forgot about it. So I've made another one, like a proper one. I think we've got our real first team with Cook, who is definitely already turning into a club legend, Buffon, Hargis, Tefty, all of our best players as well. So this will be training probably twice or three times a week, and this one to two, because we still need to keep them being trained for their overall to grow, but also their sharpness, because if they're not sharp, then it's not going to be good at all. So let's have a look at our calendar. We have got Fulham, Atlanta, the international break, Europa League. I accidentally went in the wrong one, so I had to sim through everything, and we got a win in the Europa League. So I've decided I will sim Atlanta to give us the loss, definitely, so that way we're back to where we would have been just after two games, but we'll still be on the three in case we did beat Atlanta suddenly. So we have Fulham, Atlanta will definitely be simmed, international games are always simmed, Brighton, Palace, Wolves. So I'll probably play Palace, yeah, Crystal Palace, Wolves, oh, Tottenham as well. I'll sim Tottenham, you know, because we're not going to get anything from it. So Wolves, Palace, Fulham, and then if we get time, I'll try and fit in a Brighton. So that's how the video will go. I'll see you after the first game. So this is the sort of thing that I would wait. So this was definitely what you could call a goal fest, and we went behind early on. Well, not really early on, 20 minutes in, Brighton finished. It was an okay goal, but we should have definitely defended that. We didn't track his run. And you see he just puts it, no chance to Buffon. But 6 minutes later, I don't know what the defence is doing, it's as if they've just given up. Or they just have no stamina. Izzy Brown knocks it right into the far corner. Definitely should have done better, the keeper. Matthew Ryan not playing very well at all today. As it was chipped up, he sort of just stood there. Then what? He went for it. He did go for it. I could have easily taken on the shot. He was easy finish, volley into the back the net. Then they equalised from a penalty. The foul isn't being shown for some reason, because it was a yellow card, but the penalty, nothing Buffon could do about it. As you can see, he starts pulling out his little dance and he goes the wrong way. And then in the 68th minute, I guess they all thought it was going out. Hargis had other ideas as Cook. I think Ryan maybe could have done better for that one, definitely, how it was so slow. But he sort of chips it, or he was ever so close, just underneath Ryan. And at the end, I guess if you really wanted to see this miss, straight over, terrible shot. But yep, it was definitely what I would call a goal fest, as it was a 3-2 win. Well, goal fest, but I'd say we have been competing with at the moment. It's been 1-2 nils, 2-1s. So yeah, very good result. Pomacle has happened. It was an absolutely terrible tackle on his stomach. He's gonna have to come off as well. I have sort of spoilt the scoreline slightly, but this is just hilarious. I mean, look at this. Bam! Destroys him, silly boys. He's a very, very naughty boy. We'll find out his injury later on. Absolutely dominated them. Brown managed to get us our first goal. Did a bit of a heavy touch, but whips it round Hennessy. No questions or problems asked. This one was quite a good goal from Franks, I must say. Edge of the area, right into the far corner. And just to get you already, that was not the best goal he scored today. Buffon, I don't know why he ran up there. Yeah, it was a bit of a dodgy goal, that one. I don't know why I just stood there. But I mean, this goal from Franks, it's just top notch. I mean, look at that. You can just see it from that angle. It's absolutely incredible. This is the best angle I think you can get for it. It has tons of curl. Spins around everyone into the top corner. Absolutely incredible. We deserved that 4-0 win against Crystal Palace, who are 17th in the table. Because of the way quick sims work and the long sims work, I long simmed a couple, so we ended up winning a couple of games we shouldn't. So yeah, I'll see you on a bit. Someone come in for Josh Windus, but I'm not going to accept this one. It's Sheffield United. Oh wow. I don't think this would ever happen in real life. You're one or the other. So I will obviously reject that one. I thought that was quite funny, because Sheffield United coming in and you're like, you know what? I really do fancy your star, one of your star strikers. I'm just like, oh no, really no, don't take him. They offered a good amount of money though, so if it was anyone else, would have accepted. But I just can't accept that. So we will play this Europa League game, because why not? So Austria Wien, the weakest team here. I'd say it was a thrashing. We started off with Xerxes coming on in, just simple pass across, finish. It didn't look the best, to be honest. Everything happened in the second half. Headed into, passed into Franks, who slotted it off the post and in. Nothing that special. Now this goal, right? One of the greatest goals I have scored, and I mean, I've not scored many good ones, but I mean, look at this from Cook, just there. And then a bicycle kick. It's absolutely outrageous. I'm gonna go into instant replay. And we can just see here the sure skill of him to just stop and just back heel it, flicking in the air, and then Hargis comes in, his bicycle kick. They are really linking up well. The Estonian and the Welshman are doing really well, actually. And then simple goal, Cook. That was really cheeky of him, but Hargis returns the favour. Passed across goal right to him, and the keeper's gone diving. I think he's going to pelt it. And he's just chipped it over him. If the keeper got up quicker, it would have smacked him in the face. 90th minute, Isaiah Brown. Again, nothing too special. So, there was an incredible goal, and I mean, that was a really good goal. So yeah, we'll get into the advance. And what happened in our lot? It's not letting me scroll. No, I couldn't see. Right, I'll have to go into more competitions and we'll try and find who won in our group. Atlanta got a win, a 2-0 win over Utrecht, who are negative one goal difference, and Austria Vienna on negative 10. Jeez, that's pretty sad for them. In the 37th minute, we got ahead through a bit of luck, just by where Rui Patricio's head was after it hit the post. We smacked it in his near one, came off the back of his head. Hargis was there to slot it away. Now I dropped my controller at this bit, and it was just the duvet moving Buffon. And yeah, so I dropped the controller here, and then he lost it up to Adama Traore, who slotted that away. Really not good. But Vranks managed to get a goal here. Pass across, simple finish. Took a touch. The keeper had already started diving, so we could just slot it underneath him. See, he took the touch here, the keeper's already sort of gone, and it just slots underneath him there. And in the 88th minute, Cook does the most unconvincing goal. Ferreira would have definitely scored it if it hadn't gone in, but I thought that was going to hit the post. He was so close. Windus could have easily just taken it on his own, but he passes unselfishly to Cook, who's now wearing the number 7 shirt. And it actually goes in after that whole long delay. The 3-1 win over Wolves. Vranks was our top scorer. And I'm going to be doing a little bit of transfer business out of the window. My scout has sent me lots of, I'm trying to think what they're called, paper, that's it, lots of papers. So really help out, so that is what I'm going to be doing. So as you can see, this guy is just a guy off the free agents, but he has sent me like Vinicius, Sessegnon, people like that. So yeah, that's epic. I just want to thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll catch you in the next episode of the Sheffield Wednesday. Goodbye. Well, I'm so sorry, I don't know where I am at the moment. So I don't know what's been recording or what hasn't. PlayStation's dodgy, of course. I don't know what you saw, what you missed. So yeah, I think I said see you in the Europa League or something, and then I couldn't show you the Europa League highlights, or the Wolves game, I couldn't show you the highlights or something. Or I could just be speaking nonsense, and we are meant to be going into the Tottenham game. If we are, I'm so sorry about this unnecessary chitter chatter. But hopefully you saw the absolute stunner. If you didn't, I will try and recreate it. But it was absolutely incredible. So this game, I'm going to... Oh, Windass is up to 73. I'll let Windass play. And then who else should we pop in? I could give Somerville a chance. No, I think I'll keep Hargis there. Cook is obviously in the starting lineup, isn't he? He's being absolutely incredible. Vranks as well, playing well. Luongo is checking on in the positions that they probably needed in. I think I've made things worse. Was he a plus 6 a second ago? He was plus 6. Oh gosh, I made it worse, I think. Alright, then we got Hefty, left wing back. Yep. And yeah, things are currently going well for us. I don't think we're going to get a win or a draw from this Tottenham game, but we'll see. Anyway, we have some scouting reports coming in. Anybody good? He's looking okay. No, he's not actually. We can't lie, we'd have the financial means. Ah, well, we'll just have to keep an eye on you. And if we don't have the financial means for anyone, we'll just have to get straight into this game against Tottenham. So first of all, in the second half, I mean, look at this strike from Sabitzer and Tottenham. I mean, it is just incredible for the AI to pull that off. Sabitzer's just like, bang. Top corner finish, I mean, that is incredible. Harry Kane here as well, got so lucky. Took the shot, simple into the bottom corner. Nothing Buffon could do about that one. It was a really good solid shot. It actually comes off the back of Buffon to bring it back into Harry Kane to slot into that corner. Buffon did pull out a good save though. Sabitzer keeping it in. He had an incredible game. I mean, look at that shot as well. Just cuts in. No one's on him. Oh, it was Pizzi, sorry. Buffon needs to make the save. I've got the difficulty again. But we lose 2-0 to Spurs. What I expected. I'm not too surprised at that. But as we move into the Europa League now, what is the table looking like? Standings. Let's have a look at the Premier League table. Because I remember we were top, but that was just because we were still trying to pick out the right difficulty. But we won't be top anymore. We're not in the Champions League, geez. Anymore, I don't believe. Let's have a look. We are second place to Liverpool. We had 2 losses and 9 wins. They've had 9 wins, 1 draw and a loss. And here we will be playing whatever these people are called. Who are they called? Is it not going to tell me? It's not going to tell me. I do not know who they are called, but we will find out later on. 60th minute, nothing interesting happened before that. It was a comfortable finish, easy finish. And this was a great save from Buffon. I don't know what my defence was doing, just stood there. And then look at that, this is what you need, an experienced goalkeeper who can pull off saves like that. I mean, boom, it was a good strike from the AI, to be honest. And then here we got another goal, Massimo Luongo. You can just see it about here. I mean, bam, that is power from the CDM. Don't know why he was up there. He gets over a sliding tackle. And it's just easy, picks his spot, smacks it as hard as he can, and a brilliant finish. Now this own goal, this is me being stupid, right? So I walk back to my goal, and I just went to boot it out. And then I pressed the wrong button and I just bowled it in the goal. So it was very stupid, very stupid. Look, he just chucks it in the goal and he goes to the slide, then he misses it. Wow. yeah. Looking back at that, you can just see how stupid that was. But it was a 2-1 win. Thankfully, it didn't cost us anything extra. And that is where... Sorry, I just had a drink. Ah, that was nice. That is where the video will end. I'm sorry about how random and weird this video was about jumping game to game. I don't know what I'm saying in between. So I'm very sorry about this. It has been recorded over 3 separate days, so I am getting very confused. So I just want to say thanks guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Or you face Burnley. I was going to say everybody else, but... There we go. Where we face Burnley, Newcastle, Leicester, and that team, and we might get a couple of these games in as well if we can. So that is all from me, and I'll catch you in the next one. Goodbye.